Hey everyone, how are you doing? You have Mike here, and today we're taking a look at the Apera PC60Z. So this here does come from Apera Instruments. So they've been known for almost 30 years now, making high quality lab grade precision testing equipment. So I'm very happy to be able to talk about this product here today. So what this is a smart 7-in-1 testing kit. It allows you to connect to your Android or iOS device, whether tablet or smartphone, and be able to data log your readings. It's got some really cool features that we're going to get into here in a couple of moments. So before we get too far into the testing, I just want to cover what actually all these 7 points are, just in case some of you guys aren't exactly sure. So our pH, what we're checking for, that is testing for acidity and alkalinity. The next one is going to be salinity. So for salinity, we're looking for total dissolved inorganic salts. Make it simple. TDS is looking for our total dissolved solids. Basically just a breakdown of everything that's in the water that's dissolved. EC is electrical conductivity. So for EC in aquaponics or hydroponics, to what we'll be using it for, it basically allows you to monitor the amount of salts or impurities, nutrients, basically in the water. So the next one is going to be resistivity. So that measures the ability for water to resist an electrical current. Obviously temperature, we pretty much know what temperature is. So that's what this 7 meter covers. It also covers ORP, but you need a special probe for that ORP to work. So what I want to do is just get this box opened up and show you what the device looks like, and we'll go from there. Alright guys, so here we have everything that's in the box. Let's pull out all the paperwork and see what we got in here. So to start out with, there is a quality certificate, and it shows everything that has been tested before it went out the door, which is really cool. You can see that everything has passed, and the unit here is ready to go with ship. Everything was passed and the unit was ready to ship out. Next, what we have here is the instructions of how to program some of the unit, because you can do it both within your smartphone, which I recommend because it's a lot easier, but you can also do it with a hybrid style unit with on the actual meter itself by pushing certain buttons, and it tells you how to do all that here. It also tells you how to calibrate, so you can calibrate with just using the pen. Like I said, it's actually really cool, really easy to do with the app. So I'll probably show you how to do that because it's just a lot easier to do. So the next thing that comes with this is a manual, which is very well written. And it covers everything you need to know about the device and how to set it up and how to, basically how to do everything you need to know with the device. Everything that that there is to cover, it is covered in this book. So taking a close look at this, you can see that it does come with quite a few things. It comes with our buffering solution, so it's going to come with our pH 7 and our pH 4. And this is going to give us a 2-point calibration. Now this meter here is capable of doing a 3-point calibration where it does the 4, the 7, and the 10. But it does not come with the 10 solution, so if you wanted to get at that extra level of precise, you would have to purchase that separately. But nonetheless, this stuff here can be used about 10 to 15 times without having to throw it out. And every time you pour a sample, you can actually leave it into these jars. Now these here are the calibration jars for the 4 and the calibration jar for the 7. Like I was saying, these here can actually be sealed. They have a pretty good seal on them, so if you put the fluid in it, it's not going to leak back out when you put it into the case. So that's pretty good information to know. You can store your fluid in there. And it also comes with the calibration bottles for the EC, electrical conductivity, that would be your TDS, and I believe your resistivity and salinity as well. So it comes with all the testing solutions for that. So the next thing that you're going to see up here is going to be the 3M soaking solution. So what you'd want to do with this is pour half of this into here to about this line, and you're going to want to soak your pH probe, which is the blue probe that you see here. So the next thing that you'll see in here is actually a lanyard. So the lanyard is really cool. It allows you to put it around your neck, and there is a, you can see a hole here where the lanyard hooks onto. And like I said, so you're not going to accidentally drop your meter into the lake or anything like that. I think this is really designed for, you know, field use, especially with having the Bluetooth connectivity. So if you wanted to do field samples, you can leave your device, you know, away from the lake or whatever you're trying to do your samples from. This instrument's here is used from has a wide variety of uses. It could be for anything from dairy all the way to wastewater management. So it's a very versatile unit, and you don't want to drop your meter into a vat or into a wastewater thing. So like I said, the lanyard here is really cool. It does help, and I'm going to use that. I just didn't want to take it out until I actually showed you guys all how it worked, and so forth. But you can tell that there is a space here for the lanyard, which is really nice. So I'm definitely going to be using the lanyard. Another cool thing that they put on the case itself is this hole right here. It's something very simple, but something simple like this to hold your pen so it's not going to fall over and you can get an accurate reading, which is really cool. Something that they thought of, and yeah, it's, I appreciate that. All right, so taking a look at the probe itself, the electrodes for the EC TDS resistivity are actually really cool, because what they have done is they've got a dual, basically a dual junction or double junction electrode. So that means that it's got two sensors in it, so it's trying to get double the accurate of a reading, which is pretty neat. Another thing to note here that Apera has done is inside of this blue sensor that you see, a lot of these sensors are filled with a liquid. And with that liquid comes air bubbles, and sometimes when you're taking a reading, the reading is just not right. It takes a long time to get to that stable reading. It bounces around all over the place. That could be due to the air bubbles that are inside the sensor probe itself. So with Apera, they use a special gel, so it eliminates that. So it really makes it a precision instrument, which I thought was really cool. All right, so what we're going to do now is show you the Zentest app and how it works, and just show you all the cool features that this PC60Z pen has when connected to the device. So I want to start off and just show you the different programs or different screens that you can actually use. So the first one here is going to be simple mode. It basically just shows you your calibrated points, talks about your offset, your slope, and the last time was calibrated. And as you can see, it does give you a pH number, because I'm set to pH right now. This is where I click the mode button, and this is where I have my options to click from pH, ORP, conductivity, resistivity, TDS, and salinity. So the next page is going to be the dial mode. So you can see it's got a dial here. It shows you where it is on the dial. The next mode is graph mode. So it shows you the graph from your previous attempts or from your previous test. And the last one is table mode. So at any time, I can take a picture and save this reading. This is going to go into the cloud. I could come over to my settings button at the top and click on my data. And now I'm going to see that this reading that I just put here. Now there is some really cool things that you can do with the app itself. In this sense, I can click on the note button up at the top corner. I can add a location to where I have taken my sample. So if you're doing a field sample, this would be really cool, because then you can put your exact location where you grab the specific sample from. You can name it, you can put notes, and you can even take a picture and attach a photo to this as well. So I can go, oh, my reading was so forth, which is pretty cool. So one of the other things I wanted to show you was basically how to program the pen. So you can actually program everything really simply from your cell phone, which is really nice. I like the ability that you have all the different options to change it from temperature to, from Celsius to Fahrenheit. You can put automatic hold on, backlight. You can program how long it's going to take to turn off. And then you can also adjust each of these seven settings. So pH, you can change it to different settings for each of them. Put calibration, reminders, conductivity. Basically, everything that you can do to program this pen, you can do it from your phone, which is really cool. So the next thing that I wanted to show you is the calibration, because the calibration is made super simple with this app. Now, once I click on the calibration button, you can clearly see that the screen has turned green. This is actually three different colors on this. It goes red for a heads-up mode. That's usually if something is going wrong. with your meter, you're not getting a stable reading, there's something wrong with the reading, it's going to go red. But green here is for programming. So as you can see on my screen, you take these two calibration liquids, you dip it in one, it says wipe it, purified water, dip it into the other one. So it's as simple as just pushing enter on the phone or your iPad device, and it's going to program the pH for you. So very cool, very easy to use, and this is one of the things that really attracted me to this product. It's so simple to use. Anyone who's ever used, I've had the pH pens before, and you got to program, push a button a couple times, and then dip it in and out, and comes back with an error code saying it didn't work. I, for one, have used, went through multiple TDS pens and pH pens over my years. What you guys probably don't know about me is I have a lot of aquariums, and I've been using these products for years. So I'm really happy to have a high-quality testing meter here that I'm not going to have to calibrate every couple of days. And so far, it has been a very reliable unit. So here it is, guys. This here is the PC60 by Apera Instruments. Again, lab-grade testing supplies. And very happy to be able to try this out here on the channel. So I would like to thank everybody for watching. I will leave some links down below to go check out the Apera website, as well as a link where you can pick up these products on Amazon, if they were on there right now. So I would like to thank everyone once again for watching. I do hope you enjoyed this video, and you'll have yourself a great day. Take care.